We're back for our weekly words of wisdom in the midst of Succot, as you could see here. I hope you're all having the most wonderful Succot this year. In Seattle, we've been very blessed. We have gorgeous weather. I don't know where everyone else is, but I hope you are blessed with good weather also. Have a wonderful Succot. And please God, everything will be wonderful. Here's the rabbi.
Hello, everybody. It's again nice to be able to say a few words of Torah, and especially when in the middle of Succot. In the middle of Succot, Succot is the festival that we know to be a feeling of faith that God is protecting us. That's what it is. We go out from our protective
comfort
home, and then we go out. And that is the festival of Succot. The Torah said, why am I telling you to observe the festival of Succot? Because I had you in Succot while you came out from Egypt. And whether if Succot, the Torah means just tents, that's what it means, or it means an anekavod, you know, the Succot, which is the cloud of glory, whatever it is. But there is one aspect of the Succot that the Torah says, Be'ospechem et tevuata ares tachogu et chagat Succot shivat yamim. When it is already the just the end of summer and the beginning of the autumn. That when you have gathered all the fruit of the collection of your fruits of your land, then you are going to observe the Chagat Sukkot. And then the Torah tells us immediately, Lukachtem lachem, you're going to take the four species that you have got, you know, the trog, the lulav, the trog, and the aravot here, and hadasim. You know, and then you smachtem lifnei Hashem Elohim, you're going to be happy in front of God. What does it mean, that happiness? That happiness in a way the Torah is telling us, gratitude will come automatically when you realize that HaKadosh Baruch Hu, that God really gave you after all your work throughout the year and relying on God's blessing. Once you have the blessing, you're going to be happy because of that. That means gratitude. You know, this aspect of the Torah, this, you know, what we call the dimension of the aspect of the Torah that tells us about Succot, is what really empowered and started the pilgrims who came to this country, the United States, in 1621, after having such a terrible journey and ordeal, and they came in, and the first year that he had, it was horrible for them. But once they started planting things, and then they saw the produce, they instituted the thanksgiving, a day of thanksgiving. And that's how, yeah, of thanksgiving, and that's how we celebrate Thanksgiving here. But in Jewish terms, we celebrate Thanksgiving not only on Succot. We celebrate every day. We celebrate Thanksgiving. In fact, the our rabbis tell us we are supposed to say from the moment that we get up until we go to bed at night, we say Me'a Berachot. You know, at least 100 blessings, because we want to thank God. This is the Jewish aspect of it. This is the Jewish way to be thankful for everything that we have. Yet in practice we find it and we see it so difficult for people, you know, to even say thank you. What happened is that the tendency is to grumble about what we are missing, always to complain about what we don't have. And not only that, complaining is constant, but we do not appreciate everything that we have. And when we appreciate it, it is once in a blue moon, not all the time, like what we complain about. And so therefore, It's so important to keep this in mind when we are celebrating Haggadah Sukkot. There is one fellow who, by the name of Sotheby, he used to, in his letters, he said that once he heard of a Spaniard who, when he loved strawberries, and when he used to have strawberries with him, he said that he used to put a magnifying glass. Why? To look at them so that they look bigger and better and he could appreciate them. And this is, in fact, we should put our perspective glasses to be able to appreciate what we have. There is about a grandmother who used to, he used to say, my grandmother, her vision is not so bad, not so good these days, but her perspective is great, because whenever they used to ask her, how are you doing, health-wise, she used to answer, thank God, you know, I have a couple of teeth, two teeth, and I thank God that the way they are is opposite each other, so that I can eat and chew with those two teeth. In a way, what happened is that we, not only the Torah tells us that the way to be thankful is not just to count our blessings, but to make others feel blessed as well with our blessings. And that's why the Torah immediately tells us that you are supposed to be sameach and to be happy with whom? With the orphan, with all those that are need also our help. So therefore, this festival for us, that's what we say to God, Hosanna, you know, save us, when we are taking all the aravot. And the idea, and the idea is that we are asking God for every blessing and for everything, but the real thing is will come when we count our blessing and when we bless others with our blessing as well, and share it with everybody else. So for now, tis kule shanim rabot, moadim lesimcha. It should be really joyful the rest of the Sukkot and the holiday, and we always should meet in Semachot.
Bye.
Amen.
How about the malcontent?